But the foundation that God has laid is solid. On it is written, "The Lord knows who His people are." So everyone who worships the Lord must turn away from evil. In a large house, some dishes are made of gold or silver, while others are made of wood or clay. Some of these are special, and others are not. That's also how it is with people. The ones who stop doing evil and make themselves pure will become special. Their lives will be holy and pleasing to their master, and they will be able to do all kinds of good deeds. Those words come from 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 19 to 21. When you decide to stop doing evil, you become very special to the Lord. Perhaps you have heard of the WWJD bracelets that remind the wearer to ask themselves the question, "What would Jesus do in every situation?" Now, there is a part two to that question that should not be ignored. It would be WWJND, or "What would Jesus not do?" Every day we must ask ourselves both questions. What would Jesus do is certainly an important thing to ask when seeking direction for your day, but asking "What would Jesus not do?" is a critical question to ask, especially if you have time to rest and relax, or even be involved in what is called recreational activities. I believe the way to evaluate any activity is by considering whether what you are doing is something Jesus would have been comfortable doing. Remember, the Holy Spirit is living in you if you are a follower of Jesus. Is the Holy Spirit comfortable doing the thing that you are doing right now? Well, if the answer is no, then just stop doing it so that your life can be holy and pleasing to God. Lord Jesus, help me today to not only do the things that you would do, but help me to say no to the things that you would not do. And may your name be praised now and forever. Amen.